eye view of the numbers, the way they stack up. But like I said, the health ministry has now warned that India, in fact, could indeed be entering its second wave of coronavirus. Everything that you need to know, all of these numbers analyzed. Well, we have Dr. Hemant Deshmukh, the Dean of the KEM Hospital, joining us from Mumbai to make sense of these numbers. We also have Dr. Rachna Kucheria. She is an epidemiologist joining us. Thank you both very much. Dr. Deshmukh, I want to first ask you. Maharashtra continues to remain a cause of concern. Over 61% of India's cases at the moment are being reported from Maharashtra. What are you witnessing on the ground? Is this indeed the onset of the second wave, like the center says?
Definitely. Initially, in the last month, we thought that this was not the second wave. It was small ripple within the first wave.
All right, Dr. Deshmukh, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, so what we are witnessing right now is, initially we thought that this could be a ripple in the first wave, but of late we are realizing that this is not a ripple in the first wave, but a mighty scary second wave itself, which is starting. Though the figures are very well comparing with the figures of Delhi and December, sorry, not Delhi, but December, and the number of critical cases that you saw in December are not really as high as
right.
March are definitely scary right now.
Okay, all right. The numbers definitely are scary. Dr. Rachna Kucheria, you know, we're putting out the list of the worst affected states at the moment. Maharashtra, of course, is the biggest cause of concern. Maharashtra, Kerala, Punjab, Karnataka, Gujarat, as per that graphic on our screen at the moment. The center has not minced its words when it's saying that people must be cautioned and advised against this very well being the second wave in India. How are you analyzing these numbers at the moment?
Thanks for having me. I absolutely agree with you and the previous speaker that the graph is going upward. Whether we are seeing less numbers in certain other states, even Delhi, but even for Delhi where I work, the graph is steadily going upwards. And some colleagues who work in the area are predicting that by the end of March, we'll have about 50,000 cases if we look at the trends that we have currently. So certainly we are in a surge, upward surge pattern right now. And as I've said on this channel before, that the course of the pandemic is in our hands. I know we're all tired, there's deep pandemic fatigue, and I speak for myself as well, but we have to learn to, you know, beat the virus, work with the data we are getting, and be proactive. So we are seeing an upward swing.
Yes.
I think it's in all our hands, all the public's
hands. Dr. Deshmukh, if I can just come back to you, and Dr. Kucheria, I will come back to you on these numbers as well. You know, many say that, and you know, one death is deaths too many as far as COVID-19 is concerned. We have to try and save each and every life. But many at this moment say that the second wave, and if we are indeed at the onset of the second wave, it is likely to be less deadly, leading to less severe infections. How are we drawing these conclusions at this stage?
What we are realizing is though the mortality and the case fatality ratios are very less this time, this is the fact that probably the vaccine has started working from 16 January. The virulence of the virus is also probably going down. At the end of 1 year, that is March 2020 and March 21, what we are realizing is the entire virus that is happening, the virus or the virulence is definitely the mutation is going on. Any virus in the entire world is likely to mutate all the time. And so this mutation is definitely causing a different kind of coronavirus and a different kind of COVID presentation altogether in this March 21.
Would it be, Dr. Kucheria, in your view, premature at the moment to assume that, you know, the second wave of COVID-19 in India, which the central government has said is here and we're at the onset of the second wave, is going to be less deadly? What do the numbers prima facie suggest to you at the moment?
So the early numbers suggest, and this is, remember, this is also how viruses generally behave. We saw this with influenza, that over time, the viruses, they can get more contagious, more infectious, but they tend to lose virulence. And we call this influenzization of the virus. And if we look at the numbers before, our case fatality rate, the percent of people that were dying who were infected by the virus in India generally hovered about 1.5 to 1.6% over the past year. Hmm. And in this current new surge, new wave, call it the second or the new wave, since March, I think what we are seeing is about a 0.65% case fatality rate. So if those numbers are to be held at and numbers speak for themselves, I think that there may be, we could see a loss or a reduced virulence, but that doesn't mean in any way that we have to let our guard down. As you said earlier on, one death is death too many, but this number definitely needs to be continued to be tracked and we need to keep a close watch on it.
All right, so COVID deaths in India highest since the 15th of Jan, COVID cases in India highest since the 13th of Jan. The centers warned that this could be the onset of a second wave of coronavirus infections. Dr. Deshmukh and Dr. Kucheria, thanks so much for sparing your time and joining us with your perspectives. Well,